Jesus. Today, Jesus is with us. I feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. So, I feel the presence of God here. Jesus has said in the Bible, if two or three come together, I will be in the midst. So, I believe that Jesus has come here. How many of you believe? Those who believe, can you say loud hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Once more, can you say loud hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So, today morning, while I was in my prayer room, Holy Spirit told me to share with you about how to be in Christ. How to be in Christ? Are you in Christ? Maybe you are a believer. Maybe you have received Jesus Christ as a Savior. Or maybe you are going to church every Sunday, other days also, fast prayers and other confession meetings, you are going to the church. Maybe you have the Bible in your home, you are reading the Bible, or you are an active worker in the church. But I am asking you, are you in Christ? Or whether Christ is in you? Many people believe they are internal organs. They believe they have kidneys. They believe that they have a heart. But I am asking you, have you seen your heart? Have you seen your internal organs? Have you seen your intestine? No, you have not seen. Then why you believe? Because we studied in school, the doctor has said, the teacher has said, so we believe. But the Bible says that Christ is in you, the hope of glory. In Colossians 1:27 it says, Christ is in you, the hope of glory. I am asking you, the verse says that the Christ is in you, the hope of glory. But is the Christ still in you? If the Christ is still in you, your character will be like Christ. Your speech will be like Christ. Whatever you say, that will be like Christ. Hallelujah. So I am asking you, if Christ is in you, everything, whatever you say, whatever you do, everything will be like of Christ. You know, when Jesus was on the day of crucifixion, he was lying on the cross. He had the power to break all the obstacles, all the cross, and he could come out, but he remained silent. He remained silent. Why? Because that was God's purpose. So what I am telling you is that maybe you are a believer, God has called you for a purpose. Maybe you have to go through the obstacles. Maybe it is a wilderness. You have to travel through the wilderness for a long time. But you should not murmur. God called Abraham from his family. Abraham, you come out from your house. Without any hesitation, he came out. He didn't ask where to go. He didn't ask where I am going. But after hearing the word of God, he came out. So God has called you. God has called you for a purpose. God has called you. God has separated you from your friends, from your relatives, from your place, from your land, from your country, for a purpose. You first realize that. So there is a purpose in your life. A Christian life is not a life without any purpose. A Christian life is not a life without any meaning. If you are a Christian, there is a purpose. If there is Christ in you, there will be a meaning in you. Hallelujah. Many people come to church. I ask some people, some believers, those who come in my church, I ask them, how is everything going? They will say, everything is okay. Morning we get up, we see the sunrise, evening the sun goes down, everything okay, no problem. But without a no problem is not a Christian life. There may be problems, or there may be no problems. There may be problems, or there may be no problems. But your life should have a meaning. Hallelujah. Because you are carrying in your body the Jesus Christ, the life of Jesus. 2 Corinthians 4:10 says, In order to have the life of Jesus revealed in your body, you have to carry the dying of Jesus always. So when you carry the life of when you carry the dying of Jesus in your body, the life of Jesus will be revealed in your body. Wherever you go, miracles will happen. When Peter went, his shadow also did miracles. Many people brought the sick, the lame, they brought in order for the shadow of Peter to fall on them. And you know what happened? They were healed, miracles happened. So when Christ is in you, that will be relieved. The people will come to know that Christ is in you. Yesterday, one sister called me for a prayer. She told me to come to my house and pray. And after putting the down the phone, she told me, when you come, do not take your Bible. I asked why. Or suppose if you take the Bible, you must bring the Bible inside your bag only. Don't take it out. I asked why. No, my family members do not know that I have taken baptism. If you have taken baptism, why should you have it? If you have Jesus in your Christ, in your body, why should you hide? If you are a Christ, if you are a Christian, why you are ashamed of? Wherever you go, take the Bible with you. Let the people come to know that you are a Christian. Hallelujah. If you hold the Bible in your hand, let everybody come to know. You should not be ashamed, because Jesus has said, when I come with the angels in the end of the world, I will also be shaming. I will also put you on shame if you are not willing to make my name known. Hallelujah. So you should not be hesitated to carry the Bible with you. That sister who called me yesterday, she told, when you come, you cover the Bible with a cover, plastic or paper, then come, no problem. But I am telling you, if you have taken baptism, say it boldly. Let people say, don't mind. Whatever food you are eating, that is what the food which God gave you. Whatever clothes you are wearing, that clothes is what Jesus gave you. So you should not be hesitating. Hallelujah. Colossians 1:27 says that Christ is in you, the hope of glory. So wherever you go, when you go to an office, Christ is also with you. When you are in the hotel eating food, Christ is with you. So whatever you do, you are not alone. Christ is with you. So need not be afraid. At the time of help, at the time of need, the same Christ is also will only come to rescue you. You know that. Hallelujah. Once one servant of God, he went to USSR for a ministry. It was not at the present USSR. It was present Russia, but it was the old Soviet Union. So there the Bible was prohibited. And somehow the God servant took the Bible inside the bag and he went out of the plane and he ministered in a hall. And after his returning back, some people came to know that a man of God has come and was doing the ministry. So all the police people were vigilant. They were all taking care of whether they were looking, they were vigilant because in order to catch that person. Hallelujah. But you know what happened? While he was about to enter the airport, one man came and asked that servant of God to give the Bible, and he gave the Bible, and he accompanied him with the Bible. And after all the checking was over, when he was about to enter the airport, that man gave the Bible to the servant of God. And after taking the Bible from the man, in order to say thanks, he looked aside, but he didn't see that person. It was an angel. You know the ministry of angels. The person who took the Bible from that servant of God was an angel. Hallelujah. So if he had, if that man of God has taken that Bible with him, the authorities might check him. So you know what happened? God sent this angel. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 1, 14. Can you take one of you take and read? It says that angels are sent by God to minister for the children of God. Hebrews chapter 1, 14th verse. What does it say? Please read. Hallelujah. It says that angels are sent by God to minister for the children of God, for those who are seeking salvation. Can you read that?
But to which of the angels said yes. He at any time, sit on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool? Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation?
Once more, yeah.
Are they not all ministering spirits?
No, once more, yeah. Once more.
Are they not all ministering spirits?
Are they not ministering spirits?
Sent to minister for them.
Sent to minister for them.
Who shall be heirs of salvation?
Who
shall be heirs of salvation?
Heirs of salvation. Hebrews chapter 1, 14th verse clearly says that angels are ministering spirits. They are sent by God to minister for us. I have one friend, his name is Anil. He is working in BSNL. While we are having a talk, he told me, I have sent one of the angels to go around because I was in need of money. He said like that. Hallelujah. And I have told him, why you are telling in this manner to the angel? You say in a good manner, but he said, no, otherwise they will become idle. So that's why I commanded them. Your faith must be like that. Angels are ministering star, ministering in spirits. You need not to seek a doctor first. When you are sick, don't seek a doctor first. When you need a case to be settled, don't go and see an advocate first. First, cry to God. Lord, send your angels. Lord, send the angels to help us in this situation. Many circumstances, many instances, I have seen the angels coming and helping me in many instances. So, if Jesus is with you, you need not to be worried about anything. I see a person who cannot walk. That person is having a pain in the leg. Right now, Jesus is healing you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is going to extend your boundaries. God is going to extend your ministry. So you need not to be worried about anything. Hallelujah. The enemy's power is going to be decreased. It is going to diminish if you believe, because you are carrying the Spirit of Jesus. You are carrying Jesus in you. Hallelujah. Because Colossians 1:27 says that Christ is in you, the hope of glory. How many of you believe? Those who believe, can you say loud?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, if you have the Christ in you, you won't warm up. Once one pastor, while preaching, he told me that if you have the Christ in you, first your family will come to know, then your friends will come to know, then the neighbors will come to know. And he was saying, first in your house, then your cat will come to know, because before you have thrown stones at the cat. But now the cat will be surprised, because now you are silent. The cat will be thinking, oh, that man has got repentance. Hallelujah. So if Christ is in you, your neighbors, your family, your place, everybody will come to know that you are repentant. Without repentance, you cannot say that you are a God's child. Repentance, because Jesus has said that I have brought you for a price. What price you gave to Jesus for that sake? Because Jesus brought you for a price. What price you paid? That is the price for repentance. You had the bad apple. Maybe you have been smoking. You have been telling lies. You have been murmuring, you have been complaining against God and God's children. You have been always quarreling in your house. So many problems here. You have been doing evil things. You have been looking bad movies in the mobile and in the TV. So many problems here. But have you got a change in your life? Is your tongue using for the glory of God?
Thank you, Jesus.
Are you going after the worldly people? Or are you seeking God? If you are seeking God, the first you will know that you have changed. Hallelujah. Because in the book of Ephesians 3:18, can you read that? Ephesians 3:18. Paul went to the church of Ephesians, and when he noticed that all the people were rich, they have much wealth, they have everything there, they lack nothing. But when Paul looked into their hearts, Paul found that their inner man is very weak. They have nothing. Outward they are very rich, but inward they have nothing. Can you read, sir?
May we be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth and the length and the depth and the height, and to know the love of Christ which passeth knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God.
You may be filled with all the fullness of God. I am asking you, are you filled with all the fullness of God? When Paul went into the church, Ephesus church, he found many rich people there. He found many literate people there. Many religious people he found there. They are very fat with the wealth. But when Paul looked into their hearts, he found that there was no Jesus in them. There was no Jesus in them. If Jesus is in you, you will be filled with the fullness of Jesus. You do not lack anything. Psalm 73 says, God is my shepherd, I do not lack, I do not want. Maybe you have problems, maybe you have some minor diseases in your body, some disease like headache. Maybe you have some finance problem, maybe there is some family problem, but it doesn't bother you. It should not affect you. You know, when Jesus and the disciples were traveling on the boat, heavy storm came, Jesus was sleeping, he didn't mind anything. Whatever was happening, it didn't bother him, because he knows that my Father sent me and I have sent in this world for a purpose. Until I fulfill my purpose, nobody can do anything. Jesus knows that. That's why he was come and pray. So I am telling you, you are sent in the world for a purpose. You are called as a Christian for a purpose, not for living from day and night, working and eating and wearing clothes and watching TVs. No, that's not the purpose. Every Christian has a purpose. That is to preach the gospel. Because in the book of Matthew, 28th chapter, 18 to 19 verse, Jesus has said, go to the ends of the earth, and whatever I have told you, teach them and make disciples. Baptize them and make disciples. This is what Jesus has told. Jesus has told, can you read, sir? Matthew chapter 28. Hallelujah. Can you say loud hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So, you know what Jesus said? Jesus said in the book of Matthew chapter 28, 18th verse. 18 and 19th verse, it says, hallelujah.
And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen.
So, Jesus has given us a command. It is a commandment. What is it? Go to the ends of the world and teach them what I have commanded, and make them disciples. After baptizing, make them disciples. I'm telling you, are you doing that? And Jesus has said that, if you do that, I will be with you always. I will be with you always. Jesus has said that all the power God has given to me, Jesus has said. So, Jesus will be with you always, wherever you go.
Jesus, thank you, Lord.
If only you do the will of Jesus, then only Jesus will be with you. First, when I started my message, I asked you whether Jesus is in you. Colossians 1:27 says that Christ is in you. But I am asking you, is the Christ is still in you? If only you bear fruit, then only Christ will be with you. Why Christ has come in you? Because you bear fruit. Because in the book of John 15:16, it says that whatever you ask in my name, that will be given to you if you bear fruit. Jesus has said that I have chosen, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. And whatever you ask in my name, that will be given to you if you bear fruit. Are you bearing the fruit? If you bear fruit, if you are fruitful, whatever you do, that will be a blessing. Whatever you say, that will be a blessing. What you can do, you do. Hallelujah. Then Christ will be in you. Then you will be a blessing to other people. You will be a blessing to nations. Hallelujah. So in this time, Christ wants to do something. The Christ in you is now silent. The Jesus who is in you is silent. He is silent. He cannot do anything. He wants your hands. He wants your brain. He wants your body. He wants your leg. Hallelujah. So, if you want the Christ, the life of Christ to be revealed in you, you must do something for Christ. Morning, you wake up, you work for your family, that's good. Even you come back, you have your time with your family, then you go to sleep. In the meantime, you will have food, you will have your own pleasure. But I am asking you, are you spending some time for Jesus? The Bible says that you must give time to it for everything. You must give 1/10 from all you have to God. God has given 24 hours freely for you. God is giving you oxygen freely for all the 24 hours. So, from the 24 hours, 1/10 of 24 hours, 2 hours and 40 minutes, around somewhat approximately, around 2 hours, 40 minutes, that is God's, not yours. God is giving you oxygen freely. God is not making you having any disease in your body. And God is protecting you from all accidents. You are not going after wandering in the wilderness. God is with you. God is taking care of your family. But I am asking you, in the 24 hours, God is with you. But are you giving this 2 hours, 40 minutes to Jesus? Are you doing anything for Jesus? Christ is in you. If you want the Christ in you to be revealed, if you want the people, if you want the world to know that Christ is in you, I am asking you. Maybe you are having some other job. You are having a secular job. You are having some other job. No problem. But sometimes I ask people what you are doing. They say that I am having a job in a such and such company. And part time I am working for the Christ. No, I am telling you, your job is full time ministry and part time you are doing it secular job. Maybe you are working in office, you are doing business, but that is part time. Your job is full time ministry for Christ and part time is for you work for your family. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
24 hours God is giving you free oxygen. 24 hours God is giving you sun. 24 hours God is giving you moon. God is giving you all those who are in this world for your pleasure. 24 hours you are enjoying that freely. From the 24 hours, I am asking you, can you give 2 hours, 40 minutes for Christ? Then Christ will be with you. Then Christ will be with you. I got a job in Sharjah Airport as legal manager. I was to sit in that job. But for the sake of gospel, I renounced everything. I left everything because I found happiness in serving Lord Jesus. I could come to India, I could come to my home at night and morning I can go by the Sharjah flight, because every day there is Sharjah flight from Trivandrum to Sharjah. In 2008, I got the job as legal manager. But I left that job because I find happiness in serving the Lord. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I am telling you, now this is the time for you to step in for Jesus. It is the time for your family to come together and step in for Jesus, to work for Jesus. Whatever problem you have, don't bother about it. Leave everything to Jesus and Jesus will be with you, because Jesus has promised that I will be with you always. If Jesus is with you, fire goes before you. Because Psalms 97:3 says that God is reigning. God reigns. When God reigns, fire goes before him. When you read Psalms 97, sir, can you read Psalms 97? Before praying, I am going to read that Psalms 97, 1 and 3. Hallelujah. Psalms 97, 1 and 3. It says, the Lord Jehovah reigns. It says, fire goes before the Lord. It will burn the enemies. Hallelujah. Can you read, sir? 97. Psalms 97, 1 and 3. The Lord reigns.
The Lord reigns. Let the earth rejoice. Let the multitude of isles be glad thereof. A fire goes before him and burns up his enemies round about.
Praise the Lord. Do you have any problem in your life? Need not to spend much time after your problems. Because Jesus is in you. Psalms 97, you have heard, it says, fire goes before him. When you have Jesus in you, wherever you go, fire goes before you and it will burn all your enemies, it will burn all the obstacles. It will bring all the problems in your life. It will smash everything. So you need not to have a prayer request and say, Jesus, I have a prayer request. You need not to say, because it will automatically go. At the time of coming, receiving Jesus Christ, I had many diseases in my body. I had a spondylitis. Morning when I wake up, in a week, three or four days, I will have painkiller. Because I had the spondylitis. When I iron my clothes, I cannot do iron my clothes like looking at the clothes. I do like this. Because I cannot bend my head, neck. I had the spondylitis. But I started prayer for some other name. When I started prayer, automatically after some 7-8 months, I forgot. Then I remembered, oh, I had the problem. I had the spondylitis. I used to take the painkiller. But now it has gone somehow. So whatever problem you have, it will go automatically. You need not to pray for that. You need not to spend your time. Many people, when they come to church, They come with a long petition to say before the God. Their prayer request is like, we have no house, we have no car, we have no vehicle, our family is in problem, we have no food. So you send your prayer request. Pastor, you pray for us. I'm telling you, you need not to pray for anything else. First seek the kingdom, then everything will be added to you. Because Jesus is already in you. You need not to go after your prayer request. Just spend some time for Jesus. I told you, out of 24 hours, 2 hours, 40 minutes is for Jesus.
Amen.
In that time, in that 2 hours, 40 minutes, you can read Bible, meditate, you can work for the Lord, you can give tracts, you can give message, you can do something for the Lord. The Lord will work for you. Lord will be with you. Wherever you go, Holy Spirit will come and help you, because Holy Spirit is a comforter.
Thank you, Lord.
I am asking you, how many of you are having the ministry of angels? When you have a disease in your body, tell God, send your angel. I have a pain in my body. God will do a miracle. Hallelujah. Shakabara, I am going to pray for you. Dilagamara Shakarantarastama. Let us close our eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus, I am praying for all those who are here, those who have come here, and also those who are watching through the media. I pray in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Whatever obstacles they have, whatever problems they have, Father, I am praying, it should not affect them. While you were in the boat at midnight, when heavy tempest came, heavy storm came, while the disciples were crying, you were calm and praying. Give us a grace like that. Even when we are facing problems, Lord, pour the grace like that you slept when the heavy storm came. Hallelujah. Lord, let the Jesus in them be revealed. They have agreed to work for you, do something for you. So let the Jesus in them be revealed. Thank you, Lord, for hearing the prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I tell you one thing that, hallelujah. If you work for Jesus, Jesus will work for you.
Amen.
You work for Jesus. You work for Jesus and Jesus will work for you.
Amen.
What is your duty? Your duty is to look after the kingdom of God. And what is the duty of Jesus? The duty of Jesus is take care of your family. You know, I am full-time ministry. Jesus is taking care of my family, my children, everything. I am not bothered about anything. Everything I have any problem, I will submit everything to God Jesus. And I have never broken any word from the Lord. I will be with Jesus. I am doing His work all the time. Hallelujah. So God is taking care of my everything. Hallelujah. So God is with you. May God bless you. Hallelujah. May God come you in your room. Tonight I see, if you kneel down and pray, Lord, I have heard the word, and till this time I have not been fruitful. So if you pray like that, surely Jesus will come to you. Surely God will come to you. I see many miracles will happen. If you take heed what the Bible has said, what I have said, surely God will help you. In Jesus' name, amen.